Okay, we are back here. We've transitioned back over to this BlackBerry phone video camera for a second to test it out. We mentioned the first video, it's been giving me a little trouble lately. Spilled a little coffee on my shirt. I don't know if you can see the water out, I'm washing off the steam, but it don't matter. It'll dry in a few minutes. We're just going to see how this video goes. We didn't think of anything in particular. We didn't talk about it first.
No.
So, let's see, it's 2 minutes 50. We started at 2:50.
Yeah.
3:10.
Right. Well,
let's think about something. What should we talk?
If you talk about this, I'm talking about this, you know, sexual healing.
Yeah, we said we were going to talk about that.
Yeah, you know, the reason I thought about that is because, you know, a lot of people don't connect the dots that, you know, a lot of people say sex and sexual things are naughty and this and that, you know, dirty things. And, you know, it's not always like that. You know, there's a lot of spiritual
truth.
Yeah, there's truth, there's combination, there's a lot of vibes that can be passed on through sex, I mean, good and bad.
That's right.
You know, but there's a lot of healing in love as far as sex and things go, too. You know, I wanted to touch down on that a little bit.
All right. Yeah, maybe we should talk about sex and sexual healing in this video. Let's do that.
Yeah, good.
You know, let's see how it goes.
Yeah.
Yeah, because we mentioned this the other day. I know you mentioned the same thing.
Yeah.
Yesterday, I think.
Make a Marvin Gaye, you know.
Yeah. But, see, some people are big on sex and addicted to it. Let me start with that. Like, if you're addicted to it, you're not going the right way.
Yeah.
You know, if you think you got to have this sex and to be happy and all or whatever, you're headed the wrong direction. You got to figure out another path.
Yeah.
You know, you headed the wrong direction if you did like that. It's an error. It's a mistake to be addicted.
Too much anything is probably bad for you. You know?
A lot of people are addicted to the sex, and I'm not. I never have been. In this life, I can say just flat out, sex has not been a big interest for me. You know?
Yeah.
And that's good. Spiritual teaching and stuff has most of my life. But not sex. It's good. It gives me a different mindset.
I'm kind of like this.
Up and down. Yeah.
But, you know, it's, especially as you deal with spiritual matters and you open up and you get older and things, you know, things change a lot, you know, as far as all that goes. You know, but sexual addiction, you know, or addiction to anything or too much anything is probably, they say it's not good for you, you know. And I have to agree with that, you know, but. You know, there is a lot of healing in a good, healthy doses of everything, too.
That's right.
But sex is definitely one of them.
Well, they have the such thing as, for those who haven't heard but don't know what this is, but such thing as, like, tantric sex, which is, like, an English name for it. They had the Hindu names for that, Buddhist names.
Mm-hmm.
But it's an Eastern practice that using... with a monk or yogi is another term for a practitioner, a meditator, and then the yogi, you know, is having sex with various consorts and stuff like that for spiritual enlightenment, you know, and spiritual teaching, like these, like they're learning spirituality through that. It's a special type of sex, and you know, it's a whole different thing.
Yeah, because I mean, when you have sex with somebody, you know, or make love with them, also that thing can carry on a vibe that carries with you, too. You know, it kind of attaches itself to you.
Yeah.
If you attach yourself to them, so you have to be careful. You know, also when it comes to things like that too, and, you know, you want to watch your, you know.
Well, the idea behind sex and beyond the physical part is the physical part is very important. It's what results. Metaphysically, spiritually.
Well, only thing the physical part is probably actually
a mechanism for spiritual action.
Or making babies.
Yeah. Well, yeah, that too. I forgot about that. Totally slipped my mind.
No, it's all right.
It slipped my mind. But
baby,
you're right.
Baby
making. That's why I think that impulse might have been put in humans.
Yeah.
Like for maybe baby creation or whatnot. Yeah. But the spiritual impulse is what really drives it.
Yeah,
you know,
really can really make you or break you too. You know,
because like you said, you're with this person, but you're actually passing the energy vibes back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, like that. And then it can hurt you too. It can really mess you up in those vibes.
Oh yeah, yeah.
If you have bad, the person has bad vibes, or if you're going with bad intent, it's going to come bouncing back to you fast as can be.
Yeah,
you know, karma will work out fast, and the energy will go instantly into you, and it sticks with you.
Yeah.
You can get it out, but you need to know how to do it. You know, most people don't.
So, you know,
that's the problem. So if you're just going for sex just to get a nut, you know, put break it down, you know, or to get some, you know, to get a nut or some orgasm for females, that's not the way to go.
Probably not going to pay that good unless you're a porn star or something.
It might pay off in money if you're a porn star, but spiritually, there's no payoff.
No, there's no payoff.
That's why, now God's not striking people down for not being married and not having sex and stuff. Come on, that's a bunch of BS.
Yeah.
You know, it's all right to be not married and having sex. Most people do. I know I've never been married and had sex. Jeremy, same thing.
I've never been married.
You know, he has kids. I want kids.
I've never been married and I've had two kids. And I don't think God's drawn it upon me one bit. I have a friend who believes in that. Some reason
they're just thinking about her.
Really, she believes that there's a hell to fry and stuff.
By Buddha, we below the surface of the earth.
Yeah,
like that's just literal belief.
Yeah, and I'm not talking bad about the person, but the same time when they talk bad about me, they said that, you know, I'm going to hell, you know, for this and that, you know, doing this. And I've never believed that, and it's funny, karmically, I've seen it work out where she's in the same position, so. It's interesting, so now she has to reevaluate what she said to everybody. See, why should you say to people, too, when you judge them for things? You know?
Yeah, that's going to come back, bouncing back to you like a bath. Let's say, I don't know the analogy that came, it's like a basketball slamming against the rim and hitting you in the face instead of going through the little thing.
Well, like Don Lemon said, it's a karma's going to get you, it's going to knock you right in the face, you know.
Same thing.
Boom.
Instant karma. I haven't thought about that song in a long time.
That's a very, think about music a lot, man.
You know, that's something else, too. Let's say, like, you know, the music thing is something to touch on. Let's write that down about how music has vibes.
That's true.
Let's touch on that. We're just talking about everything.
Yeah, we can talk about that.
Music does have vibes, and you need to be careful how you listen to music and the way you do it. And the focus you might think of put into listening to people's lyrics, or beyond these lyrics, it's what people's energy, their energy is being implanted in music. I've seen it before. I've seen it physically in my own eyes, the results. I've seen the energy, the spiritual energy.
Oh, yeah.
You know, I've seen what it does to people. You need to be careful.
Yeah, as a child, I was led so much by musical energy. Being a musician and things, that's musical energy. You know, regardless of what you say or think, you know, it could be negative.
Oh, it definitely can.
Yeah, it can lead you in a wrong direction. I can see why parents things have problems with certain albums and things, you know.
There's certain albums, and this is from all kinds of music, like certain albums of rock music, heavy metal, and rap, and R&B, and all kinds of music that are country music even, that have negative vibes.
Yeah, it just depends on, you know, how the one individual
who made the music is feeling. Because you're being implanted with their vibes.
Or the individual that's receiving. It depends on them, too. Because if they can be susceptible, not susceptible, more susceptible, or
you can rise above all of it in the right spiritual ways. And then you can make it whatever you want it to do. You can control it.
I don't want to out anybody in bands and say they're bad or anything, but I definitely would say that, you know, there are certain ones that led me into a negative direction, you know, being influenced as a younger child. But see, even today, like when I hear the same music, I mean, it makes me feel good. Like, you know, now it's a different vibe, you know. So pop music can really, you know, and it's also a part of how open you listen to it.
That's right. You know, that openness, you have to be. Yeah, you can't always open your mind all the way. You can't just sit there and you can, but you know, this is something that I've known all my life, that I've seen people like, oh, I gotta listen to music all the time, this and that, and say, you know, focused on this and listening to every word.